in California for over 37 years. And don't forget, everything is made in the USA. And if you're looking for a new great career opportunity, LifeSource is looking for you. So call LifeSource today. Get full service and full confidence in your water. Call them at 1-800-334-5009, 1-800-334-5009, or just visit LifeSourceWater.com. LifeSource Water. Taste and feel the difference.
Are you one of millions of people across the country thinking about retiring earlier than expected? Join us on Tuesday, August 17th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern for our brand new virtual event for you called 9 Wealth Strategies. You will get our 9 strategies that can help protect your wealth and plan your income. Register for free at EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. Your wealth and ultimately your legacy face 3 risks: rising taxes, inflation, and healthcare costs. At our special virtual event called 9 Wealth Strategies, you'll get advice on how to help protect your wealth from these risks. Our advice is based on 30-plus years of experience and managing more than $270 billion. Please join us for this special virtual event, 9 Wealth Strategies, on Tuesday, August 17th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. See how to do 3 things: manage your wealth, minimize taxes, and plan your income in retirement. Go to EdelmanFinancialEngines.com to register for free. That's EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. From here forward.
When people talk about how hot it is, I have to remind myself they're not necessarily talking about me. But can you blame me? And now, the top 5 reasons to visit Morongo. Number 5.
The Olympic pool is jumping. Jump into a cabana, lazy river, or a cocktail. It's all fun to us.
Number 4.
Keep it cool giveaway. You can get an awesome vertical meal prep cooler when you earn 500 points on your rewards card, the 16th or 17th.
3.
Moses Lunch Special. High-gain barbecue chicken in a tangy soy cilantro sauce with rice and pickled veggies. Only $20 all month long.
Number 2.
Hump Day giveaway. You can earn 500 points on your rewards card, 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., and you're guaranteed to win up to $100 cash or free slot play.
And the number 1 reason.
Roberto Tapia, live August 20th. Get your tickets now for this number 1 Latin Billboard singer's return to Morongo.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good time.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. If you've decided to sell your house, I know it is tempting to just get it listed as is, or even take one of those cash-out deals. But why sell yourself short when making just the right upgrades will maximize its sale value?
You mean like flipping our own home, Dean? We don't have the expertise or the cash for that.
I know, but my friends at Revive do. Revive knows exactly what to change, what to spend, and where to spend it. They'll manage everything for you and front all the costs. Yes, Revive fronts the cost. They get paid back from escrow, but the profit gained is all yours. How much profit? The average client makes over 200% profit on what Revive invests on their behalf. It's a no-brainer. Reach out to iloverevive.com today and see if your home qualifies. To make the most from the sale of your home, go to iloverevive.com. That's iloverevive.com.
When it comes to protecting your business from fire, Bay Alarm brings the best. Like industry-leading fire detection systems, monitored 24/7. Bay Alarm puts the pro in fire protection. Now, more than ever, Bay Alarm. ACO28CCL880138.
People are buying his art because of the name that's attached to it.
Because at cocktail parties, you can be like, oh, remember President Biden's son that was into cocaine and then hooked up with his dead brother's wife?
This is his artwork. Isn't that cool?
I had $80,000 to blow on a Hunter Biden straw paint piece.
Gary and Shannon.
Let's do blow and look at it.
Weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. If you are out of bed, you have made it over the Wednesday hump already. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. School employees in California may soon have to either get vaccinated against COVID-19 or agree to weekly testing. A report by Politico says Governor Newsom plans to announce the requirement today, and the requirement would be implemented in response to an increasing case number related to the Delta variant, and people visiting hospitals and nursing homes in California will now be required to show proof that they're vaccinated against COVID-19 or have had a negative COVID-19 test. And again, this is all because of the uptick with the Delta variant. 5:35, it's our business buzz with CNBC's Jane Wells.
You cannot drive into a shopping center and not see help wanted or now hiring signs in the window of probably many of the stores around you. So if there are oodles and oodles of jobs out there just waiting to be taken, why aren't people applying for them? And what, if anything, can bring an end to this sort of uneven supply and demand that we're seeing when it comes to staffing? We'll find out when we talk to Jane in just a couple of minutes. But now it's time to talk tech with KCLA's Rich Tamayo. You can follow Rich on social media at Rich on Tech. His website is richontech.tv. Rich, good morning.
Hey there. Good morning to you, Jane.
Man, you were super serious about this one. No punches pulled. The new iPhone sounds kind of boring.
Well, we don't have official details just yet on the iPhone, but we can imagine it's not going to be the most exciting upgrade because last year's phone was such a big change. They changed their design. They really improved the camera. So according to Bloomberg and this guy, Mark Gurman, who's kind of, you know, for some reason, I don't know how he gets all this stuff from inside Apple, but he always seems to have the inside track and he's always right. So he's saying that basically the iPhones will look very similar. The notch is going to be a little bit smaller, and the biggest improvements are going to be to the video camera, specifically a portrait mode, which means, you know, you take a portrait mode picture, now you can take a portrait mode video, some new video filters, and also some things that allow people that are pro videographers to, like, affect the video later on after they've taken it.
So not for me, necessarily. Not a necessity for me, then.
No, I don't think we're going to see the big drive to upgrade to these phones based on these new features. I think that at this point, if you needed a new iPhone, you would say, actually, I'd probably go with the 12 because it's going to drop in price a little bit when the new phones come out. We don't know if it's going to be the 12S or the 13. We're not really sure. I don't see them naming it 13, but we'll see.
Oh, yeah. First of all, 13. Who's going to buy the 13? You're going to have a lot of people who are like, no way do I want that thing in my pocket. Going back to... It's interesting to me because Apple had been doing so well, and I think we just did that story that it saw a sales surge and things were good with the 12. To come out with such a lackluster follow-up is kind of a surprise to me, unless they think that they can just hang their hat on 12 and wait till 14 or something like that.
Well, I think it fits our coronavirus year. So it's like,
True. You
know, we're not going to see a live event in person. I think the 12 is still a very strong handset. That was a device that really, really sold well for Apple. It continues to sell well. I think that, you know, they know what they've got. And yes, there's going to be the people that upgrade every year. They're going to get a faster handset. They're going to get slightly improved optics. But I think largely this phone will be something that, you know, just the real enthusiasts get, and I think the rest of the world will concentrate on the 12 and previous models. It's not to say that this is a bad thing. It's just kind of the ebb and flow of the iPhone.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, what is this new award-winning 5 Series and 6 Series TV line with Google TV from TCL?
Yeah, I find this pretty interesting because TCL made its name here in America. This is a big Chinese brand. Based on these Roku TVs. So they partnered with Roku, they made these TVs, and I recommend them to everyone. The TCL 6 Series, the Roku TV, is just fantastic. It's a great price, it's got great features. But yesterday they announced, oh, by the way, we're also going to do Google TVs as well. So now they're putting that same magic with a Google software on the TV, which is kind of interesting to me because I'm like, oh, I thought they were kind of like hand-in-hand with Roku, but apparently not. And so now you've got the same cool features, you know, all of the streaming services are available on the Google TV software, which is built into these TVs. They make them, you know, 55 to 75 inches. You've got Google Assistant on there. Now, this is interesting, Jennifer, for a lot of people, there's actually a microphone built into the TV. So you can just say, H Google from anywhere in the living room and say, play this on Netflix, do that.
Oh,
it's cool, but some people are going to say, ooh, I don't know if I want a microphone listening on my TV at all times.
Well, I have to admit that sometimes the Shmamexa in my house, when I say something, all of a sudden she comes on, scares the heck out of me because I'm like, I didn't say anything to you, lady. And it reminds me that she's listening all the time. So, yeah, but on the other hand, when I am lazy on the couch and I just want to yell at the TV and I don't want to reach across 27 dogs to get to the remote, I kind of like that feature.
Oh, absolutely, especially if you get used to it. Like if you're watching a show on Netflix and you say, H Google, resume my show on Netflix, I mean, that's pretty simple to use the TV. So that's going to be cool. One other feature that I think is really neat is if you use Google Photos to manage your pictures, basically, when your TV is not in use, it becomes a nice big picture frame of all your latest and greatest Google photos. So I think that's really cool. The prices are good on these TVs. They start at around, $700 up to $1,500. And again, TCL 5 Series, 6 Series, really fantastic TVs. I recommend them to everyone with a Roku. Now that they've got Google as well, I think this is going to be great for the expansion of this this TV line.
And Rich, as always, here's another example of me taking your advice with the TCL TVs. We have a couple of them, love them, and that's all based on your recommendation.
I know. I think I'll be upgrading to this one.
Yeah.
We'll see.
I know. Yeah, you'll have to tell me what you think about this one for sure. And finally, these Google tips and tricks. I said it. You remind me of the, the tech Maury Povich of, here is the tip for how to do this or that.
It's funny because we've been searching Google now for like over 20 years. So we all know how to pretty much search, but there are some things you can do to make your searches better. For instance, using a minus sign to bring up things that don't include that search term. Quotes, obviously we know that one, but I thought some interesting ones. My favorite I'll give you is the versus search. And what this is really handy for, let's say you see an awesome advertisement on Instagram for like a new pair of sneakers. And you're like, this brand is really cool. But you can type that brand into Google and type versus, like VS. And now you'll see all the competing brands that people compare those shoes against, which I think is a really cool.
I use this.
Jennifer, I'm not kidding. I use this search almost on a daily basis because it's so powerful. It basically, like, you hear about a meal kit and you're like, okay, well, that's cool. Well, hold on. What else is out there? And I'm not kidding. It's such a great search. That's one of my favorites. I've got like 10 more of these on the website linked up, and it's my story on KTLA today. It's just kind of fun to refresh your Google knowledge.
Oh, I'll be going there. I had no idea about the versus one. I love that idea.
That's a good one.
Especially with as much as I shop, I need that one. Rich, thank you. I appreciate it.
You got it, Jennifer.
All right, see you. Talk to you next week. All right, when we come back, it's our Business Buzz with CNBC's Jane Wells, and we're going to talk all these help wanted signs. And unemployment, you've got 10,000 jobs out there right now. In about every single city. Why aren't people taking those jobs? I'll explain to Jane what happened when I went to get a sandwich. Monday, I guess it was. And again, staff shortage kept me from a turkey sandwich. I mean, is nothing sacred in this world, Nick Pagliocchini?
All I wanted was
a freaking turkey sandwich.
Yeah, I was going to say, wait, it kept you from the turkey sandwich
or
delayed you from getting it?
No, kept me from it, period.
Okay.
I look forward to
hearing how that goes, because I don't even, okay. I'll be tuned in here.
It was blasphemous. It was un-American.
For sure. No
I
kidding.
I'm not okay with it.
Oh, Jen.
I know. Okay.
I'll make you a turkey sandwich. I know, totally first world problems, but I will gladly make you one and bring it from Long Beach.
Okay, all right, I'll take your call on it. Sounds good. What's up on the 91?
It's a pretty rough ride for the westbound commute for you right now through the Corona area. Coming off the 15, going to be the usual heavy morning delays for you as you make way through the Santa Canyon, passing Green River toward the 241 toll road. For the westbound on the 91, not looking too bad for your drive as you continue through Yorba Linda and Anaheim Hills toward the 55. Although on the eastbound side of the 91, looks like it's Caltrans crews wrapping up shop for you around Kramer Glassell or Tustin Avenue. So that's going to be slow going for you eastbound 91 from about the 57 as you make way toward the 55. Also seeing a rough go of it for you on the northbound side of the 5 Disco round. Starting to get busy for you getting out of Santa Fe Springs and Norwalk, but before the 605, 5 northbound getting through Commerce as you make way towards Slauson. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
One out of the mid strike three and a no-hitter. Clint Edward Kershaw, another sparkling chapter.
Hey, Dodger fans, come see the world champs take on the Mets on Thursday, August 19th, and bring home some new swag while you're at it.
Edward Kershaw.
You'll want to get here early, since the first 40,000 fans in attendance will receive a Clayton Kershaw World Champion t-shirt courtesy of Budweiser. In honor of number 22, tickets start at just $22 at Dodgers.com/tickets.
SoCal weather from KFI. We've got another warm one shaping up today. Low to mid 70s at the beaches. We'll be in the upper 80s and low 90s for Metro LA and Orange County. Back near triple digits again for the rest of the week. And then it looks like maybe just back into the 90s by the weekend. And then we'll start to cool it down next week. We lead local live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
Rates subject to change without notice. Minimum loan amount requirements apply. 60% loan to value and 740 FICO credit score. Certain restrictions apply. Subject to credit approval. NMLS 3290. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Lender's Law License number 6036970. Equal housing lender.
Unbelievable. Home loan rates have dropped again at IntelliLoan. Today, IntelliLoan is offering a 1.875% rate in the APR with no points and no lender fees. Did you hear that? A 1.875%. Don't think you qualify? I bet you haven't called IntelliLoan. You don't have to have perfect credit to get this great home loan. So lock in this unbelievably low 1.875% fixed rate in APR with no points and no lender fees. So call IntelliLoan before the rates go up. Call them at 1-800-918-6200. That's 1-800-918-6200. Or just go to IntelliLoan.com.
IntelliLoan. Borrow smart.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. I am so proud that since Duffy Power came to KFI, lots of homes like yours now have emergency backup power. It's an incredibly smart and affordable thing to do. Okay, but the pandemic has everything in short supply. So right now, my best generator advice is don't wait. Call Duffy today so they can make sure your life won't be interrupted during the next outage. Dial #250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. #250, Duffy Power, or find them on the web at DuffyPower.com. Set your alarm and wake up to a better breakfast at Wendy's this Friday, August 13th and Saturday, August 14th for a free sausage, egg, and Swiss or bacon, egg, and Swiss breakfast croissant sandwich. That's for free. No catch, no purchase necessary. Available during breakfast hours only.
Start your future at a California community college. Financial aid is available to help with tuition, books, and sometimes even the rent. It's time to take the next big step. Classes can fill up quickly, so enroll today at ICanGoToCollege.com.
Advanced Hair Restoration is now offering $250 off and 250 free hair grafts for the same simple one-day treatment I receive. Their standard of care always exceeds CDC guidelines, and they guarantee your new hair will grow. Call 844-333-HAIR or go to advancedhair.com.
There are no limits to what we can do together, so let's keep rising, California. Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Your actions save lives. To learn more, visit COVID19.ca.gov.
Call Service Champions for their $88 professional AC tune-up at 833-777-7777.
Live.
KFI AM 640.
Local.
And I'm our radio station.
Thank you, Tyler. KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Welcome to a Wednesday. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Family and supporters of a woman killed by a 17-year-old driver in a Lamborghini SUV have protested outside juvenile court in Inglewood to demand the maximum punishment. The teen was speeding through West LA in February when he hit Monique Munoz's car. She was killed. The teen has admitted to felony vehicular manslaughter and is expected to be sentenced in October. We're going to talk more about this next story during Handle on the News. But a man from Santa Barbara has been arrested for allegedly killing his toddler kids in Mexico. I won't go into the story just yet, but let's just say this is one of the most horrific allegations I have heard of in a very long time. Not like killing your kids isn't bad enough, but the way that this guy did it is just so over the top and bizarre. Anyway, I'm sorry to tease it that way, but we'll talk more about it with Wayne in just a few minutes. Let's turn now to employment. God, that sounds like a much nicer topic, Jane Wells. Good morning to you. It's our Business Buzz with CNBC's Jane Wells. You can follow on social media at Jane Wells. Jane, good morning.
Dane, I think I heard you in the background.
I was just saying, that was the most awkward transition in radio I've heard in a while.
Yeah, it's because when you hear that story, you're going to be like, are you, wait, what, he did what? It's I don't know what goes on in people's brains sometimes. So,
evil.
Evil. Okay. It's true. I think, honestly, sometimes I think that is the only answer, is it's just pure evil. All right, I don't know what, okay, so I have to say I was incensed Monday. I went to go get a turkey sandwich at the Bagelry in Laverne. I was not incensed at the Bagelry itself because the place is freaking awesome. But a sign on the door said, because of the, I think it's a nationwide staffing shortage, we are going to be closed now on Mondays, basically till further notice.
Yes, this is, I've seen that at another place as well, particularly restaurants, particularly in places with front-facing staff, where you, in the middle of the Delta variant, if, why do I want to go back to work, or why do I want to take a job for minimum wage when maybe I can still collect unemployment and I won't be evicted for another month or two. But it's much bigger than that. This story I have written for my bulletin, janewells.bulletin.com, Jennifer, has gotten more response, far more response than any other story I have ever done there about where are these people who are not going back to work. There are a record 10.1 million job openings. There are not even that many people officially on the unemployment list. So it's so big. And I decided to ask people, find people who are actually saying, you know what, these are the reasons I've not gone back to work. And a lot of it is at various levels, not just because of the unemployment or whatever, but it's because people have gotten choosier. They've learned to live on less over the last year, and they have learned to work from home, and they like it, and they don't want to go back into the office. Or they can't afford childcare yet because they haven't been working and they can't find a family-friendly place with flexibility. All kinds of reasons. I talked to a guy who owns two trucking firms, Ron Knuckles, out in the Inland Empire. The trucking shortage is so bad, he has raised hourly pay 30%. He has a signing bonus of $6,000. He desperately needs a dozen more truckers. On the other hand, I talked to a 38-year-old mom in St. Louis named Maggie Munwiller, who became famous on TikTok when she finally was able to get a job interview at a place that was going to let her bring her toddler son with her because it was too late to find childcare. So she put him in a little seersucker suit named his name is Milo, made him a little resume with him with all his, quote, skill sets, like he can mess up the room, and made this little TikTok of the two of them going into the job interview. That thing has been viewed 10 million times, but I asked her, you know, how hard it's been. She was a primary breadwinner in their family when she got laid off during COVID, right after she gave birth. Her husband went out and got another job. And that paid a little more. She started selling arts and crafts online. And she said it was just kind of a reset. Like, cut one, please, Tyler.
Being laid off, it's a reset for me. I feel like I'm starting over. It's hard. So I just want people to understand that it's not just people not wanting to go back to work. It's people who can't find a job or are stuck in a different spot. You can't pay for childcare if you don't have a job. You know, childcare is about $1,000 a month at least for people to bring their children.
And then I asked her, you know, she's been interviewed all over the world since this TikTok thing happened. And I asked her, she had told me she felt so alone. And when I asked her that, it really caught her off guard as she got emotional. And here's some of that.
I've been looking for stories like mine to relate to and understand and try to cope, and there was nothing out there. I couldn't find anyone. I couldn't find anyone who had been struggling like I had.
And she got the job offer. But Jennifer, in a sign of how things are, she turned it down. She said it wasn't a good fit. However, she is now working as a part-time consultant for another company. And also trying to put more content out on TikTok to talk about particularly young parents who are trying to navigate in a new world where maybe they want to spend more time at home with their kids and they can afford to because they have cut spending. They have learned to live on this. It's a very complicated dynamic out there right now.
Yeah, and I think that her story probably echoes what a lot of moms or parents in this position have been thinking, that they hear the stories that there is more flexibility out there and that, for the most part, employees right now are in the driver's seat because of these staffing shortages, but that still looking for that right job, even though you can tell she's desperate, she's still also desperate to make sure that she gets to spend that time with her child. You can see that, or that, you know, she doesn't have those costs. What a lot of people probably think is, like she said, that word reset, I think, is a great word. Because what you want to do is, you don't want to go back into the same rat race that you were in before COVID. You want to reset and do something different.
It's very different at different levels of employment. You know, she's not going to go work at Burger King. She does not have to. And by the way, she has not been collecting unemployment for months and months and months. She's not one of those who's like, hey, I got this extra money. So she was a professional, and they've learned to make things work for now. And I talked to another guy, a golf pro in Southeast Wisconsin named Jason, and he got so frustrated because when they reopened the golf courses there, the place where he worked, flouted all the COVID safety regulations, and he lost three loved ones to COVID. They took a PPP loan, he claims, and did not give him any of that money, which the whole point of those loans was to pay people who'd been laid off. So for a while, he and his wife had been already experimenting with living on her salary alone while he invested his salary. So he quit, and he said, I fully took advantage of the extra unemployment. Completely, he said, I took advantage of it. Been investing it 100% over the last 6-8 months. He said it's doing well. And now at the age of 42, as a father, he says, I've had weekends off this summer. It's been wonderful. I have no intention of going back to work as long as they haven't had to touch his investments yet. So they are living on one salary, and he's making money investing, working on his investments. I mean, there's a lot of stories out there at every level. And I talked to a couple of job recruiters who do executive job recruiting, and they're finding that they're seeing crazy counteroffers. I said, you know, forget the housing bubble. Bidding on employees is the new bubble. That if you have any sort of accounting or tech experience and your current boss gets wind that you're asking around, let him get wind. You're going to get amazing bonuses to stay. It's like nothing anyone has ever seen in the job market before.
You know, too, we just did the story yesterday on Target, and Target's like a lot of companies that are offering now these college tuitions and things. I mean, that's a giant incentive in and of itself, not to pay a penny for school.
Yeah, Starbucks started that maybe a decade ago. You know, that Starbucks has been in a long time just to try and attract employees in the first place. But now places like Target are like, okay, what benefits can we do outside of wages? And I don't know how that allows them to massage the accounting. But it's just one more, gee, do I want to go work at Walmart or Target? You know, believe me, Walmart has its own incentives, and they're going to have to up their game. The point is, wages are going up, okay? They're already up 3.5%, but they're going up, which means inflation, which is already up, is going to go up. And so it's going to be you and I. They can't. The dollar menu may have to take a break for a while because these companies have to make money, and they're going to have to pay their employees more.
All right. Jane, thank you as always. And people can read more. She's got more than just a couple of people's stories that she relayed to us just then at janewealth.bulletin.com. And Jane's going to fill in for Handle Thursday and Friday. And we're going to talk about Peru.
I know, I'm an idiot. I'm going to Peru. I don't care. I'm rolling the dice.
I've heard it's wonderful. We'll talk about it.
Okay.
Bye, Jane. Have a great one. Thanks as always.
Keep back.
See you later. All right, we come back. We are going to talk with ABC's Tom Rivers. I don't know that there is any good answer for Prince Andrew. Prince Andrew, of course, is a woman who, when she was 17, claims that he sexually harassed her, all part of his connection to Jeffrey Epstein. And if you look, he might choose to ignore the charges. Well, that's not good. He might choose to answer the charges. Well, that's not good. And in the meantime, he's going to get backlash in the media. And in the British media, yeah, that's not good. All those stories coming up in just a second. Right now, though, let's check out your drive on the 405.
In Carson, on the southbound transition to the 110 North, there's a car fire blocking lanes of the connecting roadway, and that's going to be not too bad, surprisingly, as you approach the 110 heading southbound on the 405. Just a smidgen of slowing for you heading toward the interchange. Where it is heavy, though, is on the northbound side of the 110. From before the 405, almost as far back as Torrance Boulevard, you'll see delays as you make your way toward the 405. Got an update on this or anything else slowing you down? Pound 250 on your cell phone, keyword is KFI traffic. Again, pound 250 on your cell phone, keyword KFI traffic. Westbound side of the 105 near Crenshaw Boulevard, getting reports of a couple of cars that got into it. Looks like it's the left lane that is taken away, packed and tight for your drive off the 110. But overall, 105 west out of Linwood from as far back as the 710. A rough ride for you toward Crenshaw Boulevard. 91 west is an alternate. Knock on wood, just going to be light and patchy for the drive off the 710 heading to Gardena to the 110. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
This report is sponsored by Mercury Insurance. What's better than low rates? Low rates and big discounts. That's what you get when you bundle your home and auto insurance with Mercury. Get a fast, free quote today at mercuryinsurance.com to see how much you could save. That's mercuryinsurance.com.
The Dodgers bullpen blanked the Phillies after an hour 40-minute rain delay forced Max Scherzer off the mound. L.A. won their third straight outing. USC football is one of three Pac-12 teams to make the preseason coaches poll. The Trojans are ranked 14th. Alabama, Clemson, and Oklahoma rounded out the top three. And Hall of Fame NHL goalie Tony Esposito passed away after battling pancreatic cancer. He was 78. I'm Misty Jordan.
Intelligence runs in the family. Innovation runs in the family. Extraordinary runs in the family. The 2021 Mercedes-Benz range of SUVs. Every member is waiting to impress. Learn more at MBUSA.com.
Liberty Mutual Insurance Company presents
and Doug.
Check it out, Limu. A roadside carnival.
Step right up, folks. Test your strength.
Come see the fire-breathing baby.
Let's fan out and tell people that Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance so you only pay for what you need.
Look! An email wearing sunglasses!
Limu, you're famous. Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
Summer is here, and I've already told you that the weather is heating up, so probably you're reaching for more water than you normally do, right? But don't grab one of those plastic bottles that's bad for the environment. Just fill up your favorite glass with filtered water from any tap in your house. And you're saying right now, well, I don't have filters on every tap in my house. You wouldn't have to if you just put in a Life Source Whole House Water System. You'd have no maintenance, no filters to replace, no tanks to exchange. And I know it's very kind of you that you think that I'm a natural bleach blonde. It's very sweet. But I have to pay a lot for this hair. And so anything that's going to reduce the chlorine in the water and it's going to reduce the odor and without using salt or chemicals, my hair, this bleach blonde hair, is going to thank me and my skin as well. So have Life Source create a customized system for your house just like they did for mine. Everything is made in the USA and you get installation and support for the life of your system. And if you're looking for a great new career opportunity, Life Source is looking for you. Call Life Source today. Get full service and full confidence in your water. Call them at 1-800-334-5009. That's 1-800-334-5009 or just visit lifesourcewater.com. Life Source Water. Taste and feel the difference.
You heard about the new mask mandates, but have you heard about the new government program paying your business up to $33,000 per employee? $33,000. This isn't a loan, it's a grant, it's free money. Challenge is getting your hands on it. Hi, I'm Howard Mackler, and that's why I founded InnovationRefunds.com to cut through the red tape and get you the money. At InnovationRefunds.com, our tax attorneys and CPAs are experts at helping businesses like yours to get their share of these government funds. InnovationRefunds.com does all the legwork and doesn't charge you a penny until you receive the money. Our team has helped 6,000 businesses get $450 million, and InnovationRefunds.com can help your business to get up to $33,000 per employee. Just go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on Qualify Me, answer a few questions. No risk, high reward, InnovationRefunds.com.
Business is built on connections, and with Square, you can connect every side of your business with tools that all work together. From your customers and your sales, to your staff and your schedules, everything is in sync. so you can get a head start on shaping what's to come. See how Square can help connect every side of your business by visiting square.com/go/connect. That's square.com/go/connect.
Alzheimer's disease is a national crisis. More than 6 million Americans are living with a diagnosis. Alzheimer's Los Angeles provides people living with the disease and their caregivers free support and services to make their life a little easier. Learn more at alzheimersla.org.
Summer fun rolls on at San Manuel Casino. Every Thursday in August, San Manuel is giving away a 2021 Maserati Ghibli Traveo or up to $100,000 in cash. That's right, you could drive away in a new car or cash each week. Earn entries using your Club Serrano card each time you play, and you could be one of our lucky grand prize winners. Catch the thrills all month long at SoCal's number one casino, San Manuel. Details at sanmanuel.com. Must be 21. Please gamble responsibly.
Masks are coming off, seasonal allergies are on the rise, and COVID-19 is still out there. Sneezing, runny nose, cough, and fever can be allergy symptoms. There are also symptoms of COVID-19. If you have symptoms, get tested and find out if it's COVID-19. COVID Clinic offers free COVID-19 testing for both insured or uninsured patients. Make an appointment today at covidclinic.org. COVID Clinic offers no out-of-pocket cost COVID-19 PCR diagnostic tests with lab results in one day for persons who qualify. Conditions may apply. Visit covidclinic.org to detail.
Millions of Americans are struggling to afford food for their children during the pandemic. If you need help, simply text the word food to 877-877 to find free meals for your kids. No questions asked. Just healthy food for kids who need it, right in your community. Meals are provided by local schools, government agencies, and community groups. To find free meals near you, text the word food to 877-877. This service is made possible by No Kid Hungry.
Portions of the following program will be recorded.
Neil Saavedra here. You know, lemon juice is a great ingredient for both sweet and savory dishes. The average lemon produces about 1 ounce of juice. So here's a few tips to make sure you get every drop of that golden goodness. First, you want to roll the lemon on the table with the palm of your hand. Then cut it and squeeze it lengthwise.
The Fork Report with Neil Saavedra.
KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. Welcome to a Wednesday. Thanks for joining me this morning. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. School employees in California may soon either have to get vaccinated against COVID-19 or agree to weekly testing. There's a report by Politico that says Governor Newsom plans to announce that requirement today, and people visiting hospitals and nursing homes in California will now be required to show proof that they're vaccinated against COVID-19 or have had a negative COVID-19 test. So as of today, if you're going to visit somebody in the hospital or you're going to a nursing home to visit a relative, something like that, I would take that proof of vaccine with you. I don't know how quickly this is going to be implemented, but I wouldn't want you to get to the hospital to visit somebody and not be able to just because you didn't have your little card with you. All right, now let's talk scandal with ABC's Tom Rivers. Tom, it really doesn't look like any option for Prince Andrew is a good one on how to handle these new sex allegations against him.
And yeah, kind of painted himself into a corner, and he goes on. Officially, no comment from Buckingham Palace. As we speak, he's up at Balmoral in Scotland, meeting with his mother, the Queen, and I suppose discussing the latest chapter in this unfolding story that refuses to go away. Civil case this time, brought by Virginia Dufresne. Says that she has forced to sex with Andrew of the 17 in London, in New York, in the U.S. Virgin Islands. So we'll see what says that at this point. Prosecutors say, look, they tried repeatedly to try to get that. Andrew to get a statement, to get a deposition, and they say they'll come up short. Nothing goes so far. So we'll see if he does that, his lawyers may say, look, we could put ourselves in a bigger hole because there is still a federal investigation in theory going along, and that could be a criminal case. So, yeah, any way he turns does not look good. From his point of view, he says, look, I don't even know this woman. I don't remember. So we'll see what's up about. In theory, the civil case could go to the end with him in absentia, and it could be, for instance, a heavy fine leveled against you. But that's a lot of hoops down the road.
Okay, and even before that all happened, the British tabloids, not that they haven't been all over this guy from the get-go, but then it sort of dies down a little bit. There's got to be a major revamp of the spotlight that's put on him.
Well, 2 years ago, he gave this interview.